going to a cloud-based platform.
Can I just say, or just wondering whether it's going to be effective on those devices? Because I know a number of people who've got them.
Yes.
They need them to perform their duties.
Yes.
And I wanted to make sure, on behalf of my colleagues who've got them, that they weren't going to lose the opportunity again.
Council run. And we, as I said, we are working as well to try and make sure we can securely support people who wish to use their own devices. But it is not encouraged. And we have, we were asked for an action plan last year of what we will do to remove them. And the action plan that over a number of years, we will look to either provide a secure solution that everyone is happy with, or we will have to get them. So moving on then as well, another large project that we're up to at the moment with BT is we're working to improve the wide area network, which links all of the major offices and sites that rural council occupy and use and deliver service from. That project will increase the flexibility and availability and resilience of the network. It will, for major population centres, and I'm talking about employee and member, staff and member population centres, so for instance, Wirral Town Hall and the North and South Annex complex, and other large buildings, we will be providing extra links to the network, and those links will not go in through the same duct. So they will, what they call, they will be called diversely routed. So they'll come out or go in to separate sites of buildings. So if a chap comes along and digs up the road on one side of the building and cuts through the cable, we're not going to be off the network because the cable on the other side of the building will take over and run the network. That will be that will be completed within the next 18 months. Moving back into the data centre, looking at servers, the hardware of the servers now, we have faced a similar situation with servers as we did with the laptops and the desktops, in that the operating system, very old, it wasn't replaced, it is now out of support. We have got until next July, via an arrangement with Microsoft that was negotiated last year, that takes us through to July 2016. So we will continue to be supported and get security patches. We have got a project that's underway now. We're more than halfway through it. And that will replace hardware that's no longer fit for purpose, and will replace all of the operating systems. So up to the very latest server operating system where that is practical. So there are some of our applications, particularly from smaller suppliers who focus on, say, local government, who they've got very small customer bases. Some of them do not yet support the very latest Microsoft server 2012 operating system, but they, so we'll be having to put in those cases, server 2008, which still is supported for the next 3 to 5 years anyway. So it's, what I want to do is get to a position where we are in a rolling program of updates and refreshes and keeping everything at the latest possible level, so that we never get into a situation where we were years ago finding ourselves completely in the need to spend millions and millions of pounds in one go to get back up to date. Actually, what that has done is it's stopped us from actually providing some of the more transformational systems and facilities that we need to help the council reduce its, become more efficient and reduce its costs going forward. So we're still playing catch up, but we need to actually start to leapfrog and get ahead of the game to actually help everybody else for doing the efficiencies that they need to deliver over the next few years. And finally, the largest item on the corporate risk register from an IT perspective is the data centres. The two data holes are in the same physical envelope. I found today the last disaster recovery plan that was put together in 2005, which we really need to update. And then there it pats itself on the back saying that our two data centres are 50 metres apart. They're actually both, well, one's in the Treasury Annex, one's in the Treasury building itself. They both sit on top of the Wallasey Tunnel. Oh, sorry, the Birkenhead Tunnel, I beg your pardon. So if something were to happen and the Birkenhead Tunnel were to collapse, everything we've got would just disappear down that big hop. So it's not ideal. Data centres should be a few miles apart, at least, to provide that level of distance. So if something happens to one, it will not happen to the other. Or it's highly unlikely to happen to the other, unless there's some sort of massive atomic problem. So where we are there at the moment is we are working with colleagues internally and with others, external partners, and we will be separating the two data centres. We hope that the first step of that will be that we'll have contracts in place and have half of our estate in a partner data centre or data centres locally, but away from our Treasury building. So that, again, if something were to happen to one of our data centres, nothing would be seen or felt by our users. Everything would carry on. So we would have a complete mirror and we would just carry on. Now, I have to say, of course, with the best will in the world, even with huge budgets, banks fail in their IT, and RBS, NatWest, Ulster Bank were out of action for a long, long time. So what we will be doing is the best we can, and we will be mitigating and minimising the risk, but we cannot remove the risk. I don't think anybody can ever fully remove the risk that we will have an IT failure. But our plans are in place to minimise the risk wherever possible, cost effectively.
Am I right in assuming that any locations considered would be council-owned properties? Surely we wouldn't put it in a property we don't know. I've heard the rumour that we're going to put it in Cheshire Lines building, which we've been trying to get out of for a long while.
No, we have put, temporarily at least, we have put some of our backup equipment, the equipment that backs up the applications, we put them in Cheshire Lines, temporarily at least. And that is because the worst thing you can do is have your backup in the same room as the main systems, because how was
it? I understand that, but I assume the long-term solution would be for it to be in a council-owned building.
Not necessarily. We are looking at all possibilities.
We've been trying to get out of the Cheshire Lines lease for years,
haven't we? What I'm saying is, currently we don't need to actually own a building at all. No. We don't even need to own a server. Mm-hmm. We could put it all in the cloud.
Could be a public sector partner.
It could be a public sector partner. As I said, we are talking to one public sector partner at the moment about sharing some space with them. There are a number of commercial offerings that are government approved.
No, I understand that, but I would like to be sitting in a meeting being told that one of the reasons we can't terminate our lease for Cheshire Lines is because we've got our servers in there.
We're not putting any servers in there. We have backup equipment in there, but whatever we're putting in there will be removable within a short space of time. We'd have to plan it, and it might take us a few months. But we're not going to be coming and telling anybody, as they did maybe 10 years ago, years ago, you can't move out of the Treasury building because of IT can't move. Well, that is was never true, and that is not true today.
This is a short term move, there's still time to put up meetings on all this.
Yeah. All the worrying things happen, you might go down the salary.
Yeah, can I just ask a question then about timescales? Because at the moment it says that you're looking at the possibility of co-location. So you're saying that's a definite route that we're going to go down, and I was just interested in some of the timescales.
Barring anything going wrong, we're waiting for approval on the other side, from the other side of our public sector partnership. We're hopeful that that will come soon, so we can share the identity of that partner. And then we are reliant upon legal and procurement telling us that we are okay to just sign the contracts and negotiate those contracts. All things being equal, I hope to have our data centre out by the end of this financial year and fully operational.
Just a very quick one, bearing in mind that data processing, for lack of a better that way, is increasing exponentially, the ability to do so, and the ability, what's required is how long do you think the system you've currently got in place is going to last before they come updated?
Well,
it's a $64,000 question.
We can, what we are updating now, and what we have put on people's desks in the last year will service on the desktop will service 3 to 5 years. The servers would hopefully service 5 to 7 years. However, things change and requirements change. We will be constantly looking at that from now on. We have annual, almost constant review to make sure that as things change, we keep up to date.
I think it's very impressive with an argument about how whether staff could work out and how they work at home or work at other places.
Yes.
Assuming that all these problems about security and data have been solved, so that can be done. So if a member of staff wants to do things at home, they can.
Absolutely. Everybody who's got a laptop now and who has the key fob, VPN key fob, can do that now. From here or from anywhere that they can get a blank Wi-Fi. I have to be clear. We cannot support Wi-Fi from, say, Starbucks or Costa Coffee or anywhere else that demands that the first thing you do is when you connect to the Wi-Fi, it'll throw up an Internet Explorer page and ask you to log in and identify yourself to them. And again, that comes back to the government regulations under the PSN regulations that say that actually the first thing they must do is identify themselves to us. And the only way and then the route out to the Internet must be through our service. Those facilities that you get in Starbucks and other places are known in the trade as captive portals. They present us a big problem. We're looking at ways that the government will allow us to make those available because, of course, they are free. But I would just like to say, categorically now, I had an operation on the 3rd of July. I was in hospital for 4 days, which is 2 working days and a weekend. Until the 1st of September, I was then working from home. Since the 1st of September, I've worked 2 days at home, 3 days at home and 2 days in the office. I have not missed any work. access to all the systems I need through the technology that we have installed that is available to all members and to all staff.
Did you think
with
a microchip
that would be useful?
It wouldn't.
You heard about the peaks and troughs of the stopping and starting to work and money being in the kitty and unspent a couple of years ago. What I'm working out now is what would it be, because things cost change, so but what would be your expectation of what we need to put in each year? To say, keep going, not have peaks and troughs, stay abreast of things. What do we need to budget for to get the stability going forward?
Looking backwards at my experiences at Blackpool and Darwin, which was only 4.5 years prior to working here, my experience walking into Blackpool was the same as is here. Every now and then, falling to bits, not, you know, out of support, in dire need of tender loving care and a lot of investment. We never increased the budget, but we remained abreast of technology and still managed as well to get to a position where we were implementing new systems that could actually improve efficiency rather than stop the rot. So the current budget we have, I eventually feel that once we've spent the money that's been allocated for the remedial work, we should be able to provide IT services within that financial envelope and perhaps even reduce it.
Any more questions? We've got a recommendation there as a report for transformation of resources.
Yeah, it went to transformation and resources in the team last week, and they will be putting